Paul, I can't imagine you've had too many better days than that as a football manager.
Yeah, it was, first of all, it's a fantastic win for us at this point of the season when the stakes are so high. And I was in confident mood going into the game based on our performances against Stoke and Manchester United also. But coming back here, I had a feeling that there would be a really good atmosphere today. I think our supporters were unbelievable in getting behind our players. And we played against a really good team as well. You know, we found it hard to have as much of the ball as we would have liked, especially in the second half. We got pinned back, but it was a magnificent collective effort defensively to get the right result.
Going into the game knowing Hull had lost, I mean, that's obviously got to give you a big impetus, hasn't it?
We knew that they were going to play first earlier in the week, and we said, listen, whatever happens in that result, and even today in the pre-match meeting, we said, whatever happens in the result for Hull, we need to win. Because, you know, if they win, we've got to keep that gap at 2 points going into the last two games. If they draw or lose, we've got an opportunity to get out of the relegation zone if we win. The last thing I said to them is just go out and win the first half, that's it. Went and did it and delivered. And then we could talk about some other things. But in the end, it was spirit and determination and perseverance that got the result for us.
Does the fact that you, you must have known those results, obviously the Palace result and the Hull result, does that, notwithstanding what you just said, does that free you or does that add pressure on when you know those results?
I think what it says to everyone is we have an opportunity, don't waste it. And that was the case. And it ended up being a positive weekend, but we know how quickly it can swing the other way. We've had it ourselves in a positive way. We've had it in a negative way. We have to make sure now that we are absolutely focused and prepared to get a good result next week at Sunderland.
You were 1-0 up against Spurs with things getting tight at the end. You didn't hold on there. You did hold on here. What was the difference?
I think the difference was probably that we had experienced that, and you know that it can happen. It was in the back of my mind around 82, 83 minutes that what had happened. I'm sure that was the case with the players. You don't forget those kind of things. But, you know, mentally they stood up to it.
Paul, you'll have a full complement of supporters, 3,000 supporting you next week at Sunderland. Where did the idea come from for the players to pay for the supporters?
Came from the captain, Leon. I think it's a brilliant idea. And shame we can't bring everyone because, God, if we could bring what we had today, it would be a massive help. But it's great that, you know, that's been done by the players, organised by the players, led by Leon. And we hope they get up there safely.
You had Llorente, he scored you 13 goals now. I think he cost the club £5 million. He's been, you could argue, he's been one of the best signings of the season, the way he's brought to the club.
Yeah, crucial goals. I think the most headed goals as well. You know, he's so dangerous in the box, and if you get good service into him, he's very difficult to control.
Well, a lot of people had questioned Fernando's commitment and, you know, made a thing of his sprint speeds. He kept popping up all over the place today. He was a right backer at the summer league game. Mm. Must have been delighted with his defensive efforts as well.
Yeah, the whole team collectively. And we talk about it all the time, that if you want to defend well, it's not your goalkeeper and just your central defenders. I thought were excellent today. It is a collective effort, and our physical statistics over the last three games show that we're really working hard. Fernando's never going to rack up high distance in terms of sprint meters, but he offers a lot of other things in terms of his personality, his size, and his power.
Played against the top scorer in the Premier League today, and look after you get one shot on target. I mean, pleased with how your defenders handled him.
Yeah, the two central defenders that came up against him knew they were playing against a top striker today. Someone that's got great qualities. There's not many strikers around like him that can do a little bit of everything. He's got good technique, he's powerful, he can attack crosses, he can hold the ball up, he can run at you. So they had to be really, really concentrated, and I think the two of them working together generally kept him fairly quiet.
Theoretically, you've got a more straightforward running than Hull. How can you, as a manager, prevent those thoughts of thinking, yeah, this is job done then?
Well, just the fact that what happened today with, you know, with Hull, I'm sure everyone was thinking that's a home win for Hull, and it didn't happen. And we've had games where people, ourselves, fans, were expecting us to do better and we didn't. And then games where were much tougher for us and we've picked up results. That's the nature of football, and it's especially the nature of this league where any team can beat anyone on their given day if they're really firing to their potential and the other team has an off day.
Leon Britton's already a hero for the supporters, but today, again, he was a bit of a colossus, wasn't he? Any words about Leon's
performance? No, he was fantastic, and he's been really, really great ever since I've been at the club. You know, the fact that he didn't play any minutes until the Stoke game underneath me, but stayed so professional, supported the players when he was on the bench, supported them when he was out of the squad, helped me with lots of things in his role as club captain, came in to the team, did his job again, and you can see he has a fantastic connection with the crowd. Really nice to see.